Hello, thank you. So, my name is Tim Breuer from Plastic Playgrounds. The ocean, a beautiful, pristine environment, and one of the most important ecosystems for us humans. Without the ocean and its resources, we would not be able to exist. And I had the incredible opportunity to explore this vast landscape and sail across the Atlantic Ocean. For me as a pirate, a dream coming true. But we are also on a mission to do research to the plastic pollution. This is the boat we used to sail from Bermuda to the Atlantic, to the North Atlantic, to the Azores, to the North Atlantic plastic soup. Islands doomed out of the mist, where we had to stop for provision. We had amazing sea life around our boat, day and night, like this dolphin. I saw the most spectacular sceneries, sunsets, moonsets, and clear starry skies, like we were floating in space. I swam in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, in the deepest, bluest water I ever seen. And this is how it looked like most of the time, clean and blue. But we also saw lots of plastic. I came across many of these sites, ghost nets. They're also referred to as ALDFG, abandoned, lost, and discarded fishing gear. When they enter the ocean, they keep doing what they're meant to do. They are trapping animals. And because of this, they are 4 times more deadlier than any other type of debris in the ocean, any other type of plastic debris. And I learned around 640,000 tons of fishing nets enter the ocean every year. And they're responsible for killing hundreds of thousands of marine animals. For example, the turtle, but also whales, dolphins, sharks, fish, seals, and seabirds. So it's an ecological disaster happening at this moment, and a problem that needs urgent attention. And I found out that in Turkey, they recognized this problem. And the last 4 years, they implemented a program in which they removed almost 400,000 square meters of fishing nets from the coastline. So well done to Turkey. So I want you to let this sink down for a moment, because I want to talk to you about another passion of mine, and I think of so many others, sports. Sports, they bring people together, and they are really important for our well-being, for our physical, but also mental health. But still, sports and sport events are far from sustainable at the moment, and a lot of wastings are generated every year, while they could be circular. So now we have these two different subjects, fishing net waste and sports. And we were thinking, wouldn't it be amazing if they could benefit each other on the road to become circular? So we were looking at these two subjects and think, where do they actually meet, these two environments? And we found out this is at the beach, where we go to play sports. But we also see a lot of fishing activities and abandoned fishing nets. So we had the beach, we had sports, and now we also had this pile of fishing nets from which we had to make a new product. And suddenly we came with an amazing idea. And from this idea we created a product and a business concept. Would you like to know what we came up with?
Yeah.
All right. So I'm honored to present to you the first circular sport in the world, in which we only use recycled waste streams to make the equipment to play it. And it's called Beach Atom. Thank you. So the Beach Atom paddles we make by recycling fishing nets. And the Beach Atom nets, which should have been there, but aren't, we made from repurposed fishing nets. So by playing Beach Atom, You're not playing only a fun new sport, but you're also contributing indirectly to cleaning up the ocean from fishing net, and you're stimulating circularity in sport. Next summer, Olympic year, we're gonna produce 10,000 of these Beachathon paddles, which we sell to people that love the ocean and want to invest in the ocean by playing a new sport, but also people that want to just play a fun new hip sport. So it's not only the people that care for the ocean, but also others that can contribute to cleaning up this beautiful area. But this is not all, because we're also gonna offer a Beachathon experience. We already saw lots of cleanups are organized every year, but what is done with the waste? Well, we found an answer to that. We started a project, the Dare to Beach Different Cleanup Tour. Well, you see, you know the problem of the fishing nets, but we will go together with a school, a company, or beach lovers, and do a coastal cleanup. And with the plastic waste we find, we will directly, hands-on, recycle them into Beachathon paddles, which of course then we will use to play a fun game of Beachathon. And we are using the newest technology for making mobile recycling machines, so people can recycle the plastic directly on the beach and see how circular economy works. And we can not only make Beachathon paddles of this, but also any other type of product. So, with this project, we create awareness, we provide education about circular economy, but also give people help by playing a sport. And we are aiming bigger, but we're aiming even bigger than this, because I'm so happy to tell you, we got invited as Plastic Playgrounds to go to Tokyo, the Olympics, to show our project there. And this is the start of a 4-year project we're gonna implement, which is called the Road to Paris. In these 4 years, we're going to use Beachathon to showcase circularity in sports and startup discussions. But also, we will consult the Olympics, but also other sport events, how to make sports more circular and waste-free. So in 4 years, Paris will be one of the most circular sport events ever. But we didn't forget our main goal, which is to clean the oceans. So 5% of all our revenues will go to clean the oceans with fishing nets. And we're already in business. We have a product, the Beachathon paddle, and we already sold them. 20 examples. We provide an experience at the University of Wageningen. We are playing Beachathon at the moment. And you're looking at the first Beachathon trainer in the world. So we're also creating employment. And we are consulting for Tokyo, the Olympics. And like this, we're contributing to 4 different sustainable development goals, which we also find very important. So I ask you to join this Beachathon revolution and help us to save the ocean and the marine life, fishing net pollution, and make sports circular. I dare you to beach different. And to close off my presentation, I want to share with you one particular moment in this amazing ride I already had. To make my first prototype, Beachathon paddle, I had to wash 25 kilos of fishing nets. And while I was doing this on my roof garden for 8 hours, a certain image came to mind. It was the car of Elon Musk flying to the moon. And I thought, how is it possible that we have the technology to accomplish this? And I am standing here washing fishing nets with my bare hands. But it also made me realize there is still so much more possible. And we're just starting to recycle plastic from and plastic fishing nets. But to make this happen, we just really have to want to do it. And for that, we will need your help. So please invest your tokens in us. Plastic Playground to make this work. That's it.